okay, I want to share my experience. Before seeing Swamiji, whatever food which does not taste nice, I used to not eat it. I used to just throw it away and not eat it. So in this Kodaikanal IA, I got an experience. One day in the hotel, they were giving donuts. Okay, and Swamiji took the donuts and he was asking, what is this, what is this? Then somebody told, it's an idli with chocolate on it. So Swamiji thought, oh, it's an idli, so I'll take chutney and eat it. So he dipped it in chutney and he started eating. Then I was thinking, how is he taking something sweet and dipping it in something salty and spicy and eating it? Then I was just thinking and seeing. Then he explained that true gods and goddesses, they don't eat because of taste. They eat because it's good for their body. So you should see the context why people eat and you should eat according to that. So then I got a click from that moment that every food, it does something good to you. So you should not judge it by how it tastes. You should just eat it.
I would like to share my experience, which happened recently here in the same Sabha at March 22nd. Actually, I was supposed to come for Vakira Sadas. Then at the last moment, it was decided that I will continue with the meeting which is going on in the other hall. I'll be helping them in the audio system. Then after meeting, everything got over. I packed up everything quickly and then came to the Sabha around 6:20 or something. And then when I came, I saw Swamiji sitting here in the Simhasan, conducting the whole Vakya Sadas. So in between, he was answering them and he was there sitting in the Simhasan and conducting it. Then I packed up everything and then I came into the Sabha. There's no place over there, so I sat beside the Simhasan. Then I was just sitting. Swamiji, the moment I came, Swamiji saw and smiled at me. Then I also smiled at Swamiji. Then after some time, I thought, wow, after a long time I'm sitting with Swamiji, it is so nice. Then I thought, what if suddenly Swamiji calls me? And then immediately he called me and then he spoke to me. Then again, then I went back and I sat. Then I thought, wow, Swami suddenly spoke to me after a long time. Then again I thought, what if Swamiji looks at me and smiles at me? Then I looked at Swamiji, Swamiji looked at me and smiled at me. Then again I thought, what if Swamiji calls me and speaks to me? Again he called and he spoke. Then by this what I understood is he just did it. So by doing this, he just made me realize the oneness with him. The oneness which I had with him, he made me realize this.
Okay, I just want to share my experience. So last week, we were supposed to write an exam and we were all getting ready and we started writing the exam and one of my friend came and he just shouted at me and just walked off. So I just felt so irritated and really upset. This is too much. Every day he keeps shouting at me and just I started crying. And then I didn't know what to do. And then I just felt like, just told like, yo, Swamiji, you have to really help me. I'm feeling really hurt and really bad. It's becoming too much. I don't know what to do. I just want to see you now. And then after 10 minutes, one of my mentor came and called a few of us and told, come, let's go to Raja Sabha. Swami is calling all of you. So we were just walking to Raja Sabha and Swamiji told, come and sit in front. So we were like, I was just straight in front of Swamiji and seeing and just looking at him. And I didn't know what to do. I just felt like the moment I thought that I want to really see Swamiji, he understood my space and the compassion and love he had for me. He just brought me there. And then there was a meeting going on. And then he was telling them during the meeting, you will see all my balasins, they'll be in different places and countries and radiating the friendliness and just living like me. So I just felt the love and compassion he had towards all of us is so much that he just wants all of us to just like be like him. So I just felt so thankful to Swamiji to bring me here and live like him here.
So when I was in the cruise IA, that time every day Swami used to like, he used to give so much attention and he made me and three more kids sit in front and he used to play with us and tease us and every day in the IA cruise. Then I was thinking, why is Swami giving so much attention to me? It felt as if like something was wrong when if he gives attention. So on the last day of darshan, and whenever I think that Swami should be around, what if Swami comes suddenly there and I see him? And whenever I think that, it just happens. Suddenly I'll be running to the restaurant and Swami will come in the way. So like that, I thought Swami giving attention is like something really wrong. It's like something is not right with that. Then I told this to Swamiji on the last day, and Swami told, there's nothing wrong with that. He told, you are my favorite, and he gave a hug. And that time my pattern of that attention need and all that just melted away into his love.
I want to share an experience. So this was during the Atirudra Mahayaga, which happened in the ashram. So that time lots of people gathered, and it was a very big celebration in ashram, and lots of Mahamandaleshwaras also came, and many other Swamis also came, and so many different people. So that time Swamiji called the Balasins, all of us, and he made us chant along with all those people the Rudram and do the Homa along with them. So we are all like enjoying the whole incident and chanting. So that time what happened was, during the conclusion of the Homa, every day there was a conclusion. So that time they used to sing different songs to please Mahadeva. So then suddenly in the middle, Swamiji called me. He was sitting on top of the stage, and we were all sitting down on the Manapalage and chanting. So Swamiji called me, and he called me on the stage. So I went to him, and Swamiji told, hey, will you be able to chant Mandiram of the Nere there? So actually I learned this long ago when we went to Madurai. That time we learnt it. So the moment Swamiji asked, I told yes. Then it got down the stage, and then all different self-doubts and everything came into me, like telling that these many people are there, these many Swamis are there, and you have to chant in front of Swamiji also. Then I thought, yo, how will I be able to do? If I mess up, then what will happen and all that? Then I thought, no, nothing like this is going to happen. Swamiji has told, Swamiji will make it happen. Then I just went, and then it was, of course, I started taking other devices and checking for where the Mandiram of the Nere, getting the lyrics and all that. Then something happened, everything aligned, and I was able to present the whole thing out, and the whole thing went on very nicely. Then I understood that, like, even in a big thing, if Swamiji is telling you something, the moment you tell yes to Swamiji, naturally whatever he tells happens in you, and whatever energy you need also, everything is given, and Swamiji makes sure that you do it also. So this was the experience which I got that time.
This is the biggest gift, greatest gift you can give them. If your parents, father or mother, above 60, alive. If you are from India, you will even have grandparents alive. Because I have seen my great-grandparents. I have seen my great-grandmother. My mother's mother's mother. So it is usual in India, especially in Indian villages. So you may even have a grandparents who are above 60. Please listen. This is the greatest gift you can give to your parents, because they don't even need to understand language. Sometimes you may say, oh, they understand only Telugu, they understand only English, they understand only Hindi, they understand only Tamil. How will they do the program? They don't need to understand, because it is a Shivoham process. It is Shivoham process. They don't even need to understand. It is just straight transmission of energy. Second, they may not, people tell me, complain, oh Swamiji, I want my parents to attend IA, but they won't be able to do all the process. Their health does not permit. Here I am telling you, Varanasi, they don't need to do any process. Let them sit and receive the gift of Shivoham. Third, why Varanasi? That is the place to prepare somebody for the higher journey when they leave the body. That's a place for liberation. So I tell you, first thing, if you decide and you are able to convince your parents, just file the intention. Money, time, everything will appear. Everything will appear. Don't worry. There won't be any obstacle. See, in Tamil there is a proverb. There is a saying in the beautiful verse. Avanarulale avantalvanangi. Means, only with His grace you can even bow down to Him. You can even worship Him. So I am telling you, only with my grace you can even attend inner awakening. I am showering my grace. File the intention. File the intention. You move just your small toys to be with me. I'll move the mountains for you to be with me. I'll move the planets for you to be with me. So understand, this is the biggest gift you will give for your parents and grandparents. So, and one more thing, the arrangements are such, even if they are elderly, if they are not that too well to do any process, don't worry, just attending Shivoham process, that is enough. See, the Varanasi inner awakening is going to be both. I'm going to speak on Kathopanishad, death process, the morning satsang. Second, there will be classes on completion, all that, pranayama, kriya, everything. And then there will be Shivoham process. Your parents, if they are not able to, they don't need to go through the kriyas, but they can sit in the Shivoham process and just receive the gift of Shivoham experience, highest experience of consciousness, and greatest gift you can give it to your parents. Actually, you can't give. It's only Master can give. It's the greatest gift you can receive from the Master and give it to them. Or it's the greatest gift you can make them receive from the Master. So don't miss anybody who has parents above 60 or grandparents alive. See to it they are there in the Varanasi Inner Awakening in May. Understand, Varanasi is the place for learning, experiencing, preparing yourself for a journey of enlightenment and to move beyond death. And I can also assure, anyone who attends Varanasi IA will have painless death. They will have painless death, and I'll see to it they are liberated. Understand? Just fill the intention form, you will see everything follows. Everything happens, and we are making the whole Varanasi Inner Awakening elders friendly. Means making wheelchairs available, making as much as possible elders friendly. The earlier you send the intention and do the registration, you will get the place to stay inside the hotel where the program is happening. And we will make the Varanasi IA as elders friendly with all our efforts.